Good morning. Today is June 3rd, 2020. My name is Father Trap, and I would like to welcome you to today. Please be reminded that we upload new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 6 a.m. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to be notified whenever new episodes are uploaded. With that out of the way, my friends, let's begin. My brothers and sisters, we have all been discouraged at some point in our lives. However, I want us to get into the habit of looking for the silver lining in experiences. And when we find it, to hold firm to it, rather than looking at the gray clouds that might encompass our lives. We are reminded by Pope Francis, the Roman Catholic leader, that we must never yield to discouragement. Do not lose trust. Do not allow your hope to be extinguished. Simply because, no matter how down we may feel, we are reminded of God's presence in Psalm chapter 34, verses 17 through 19, which states, "When the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and rescues them from all their troubles. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord rescues them from them all." Friends, it might sound crazy for me to say, but I want us to lift ourselves above the downside of life. Simply because we always have to remember, a discouraged soul is a helpless soul. Let me repeat that. A discouraged soul is a helpless soul. In other words, a downed soul is like a weakened immune system. It can do nothing to protect us from the things in life that are meant to hurt us. And the medicine for a down spirit can be seen in our reading for today. It reminds us, my friends, that God is always on our side. And He continually hears our desires and needs. We also need to fill our lives with people who can help us on our spiritual journey. We need, my friends, to remove the vipers out of our lives. This requires us to take the time to evaluate our lives and to consciously think what in our life is destroying our spiritual, or better yet, who in our life is destroying our spiritual journey. At first, we may not be conscious of this. Still, as we decisively and rigorously snub every inclination toward doubt and depression that assails us, we will soon be made aware that the powers of darkness are falling back. God, my friends, is on our side, and all we have to do is ask for His assistance and guidance. Friends, please remember, discouragement is often a mask for fear. And the remedy for anxiety is a spiritual vision. I invite you now to join me in prayer as we lay down our vision to God's mercy. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Abba, Father, help us to recognize that You have called us to be faithful, not successful. Help us to focus our efforts on pleasing You alone, not people. We will not take on more responsibility than You intend for us. We will be careful to humble ourselves as faithful stewards, whatever the outcome. Through Jesus Christ, our benevolent Son, our Lord who lives and reigns with You and the Holy Spirit in oneness and power, now and forever. Amen. Friends, although God can take the plans of the enemy and use them for our good, do not be discouraged. We must also see these as spiritual acts that they are. Therefore, we must keep our mind and heart in gear, ready to stand against our adversary and receive, my friends, the promises of God. As usual, I would like to thank you for tuning in. And as we always say, make today your best day. Until we meet again.